Open Season TV, brought to you by Dead Ringer Hunting.
No matter where we are, we keep the calls ringing. The bulls on knocking, the 12 gauge singing. Through the reeds and the swamp and the trees in the heartland. Well, it's a way of life and it's what we love. Folks around here can't get enough of that open season. Bucks and bulls and full camouflage from a duck. Tree stem, we gonna track them all when they break it down. Yeah, they better keep one eye open while they're sleeping, cause it's open season. Yeah, it's open season. Bucks and bulls and full camouflage from a duck blind or a tree stem.
This week I head south of the border to Mexico with the Lopez family and chase whitetails.
And our cameraman Hunter gets in on a little action too. So this is another one of those trips where you met this guy on the internet and you went there last year and killed a heck of a buck and now you're coming back for year two and it doesn't disappoint.
You know, I was excited. The Lopez family and their ranch, they call it Las Cuevas Ranch, is just an amazing place. Last year I killed a stud, but their management program is awesome. They don't shoot bucks till they reach 7 years old. They don't shoot a call buck till it reaches five to make sure that that potential is there and that they reach the maximum they can get.
It's mine and Hunter's first night here in Mexico, where I'm with the Lopez family at Las Cuevas Ranch. I was here last year, killed a beautiful seven-pointer, just a monster, so they've been seeing a lot of good bucks. Same management program, I'm looking for seven-year-olds, so I'm hoping to kill a nice eight-pointer or something in the 150 range. If we see one, if not, I know we're going to see some great bucks and some great potential bucks, so hopefully we get done tonight.
Covert. Code Black Pictures anytime, anywhere.
I thought we were checking trail cameras.
I have been.
This one.
Nah, blue's better.
You're gonna regret that.
Where'd that hit?
Should've got a limb driver.
Don't be a chuck. Get a limb driver.
You know, last year I killed on the first morning I hunted, so the first evening we were going out, I was excited, but I was not prepared for what was about to happen.
scared my pocketbook, couldn't handle it. Why couldn't it be a big eight? Like 150s, 140.
So this buck comes in right away and you're not shooting. I mean, it looked like a perfect shot to me.
You know, I was heartbroken when they went away with that doe, but the way he came in, and we were set up in that blind and we couldn't move. It was pull up and shoot and that was it, but Hunter was actually blocking me with the camera, so I couldn't make the shot. You know, I was so lucky that buck came back like 30 minutes later, but once I shot him and we started tracking him, man, the trauma and the blood is just ridiculous.
Yeah, that's the reason why we shoot it.
Pablo wanted to guide us again, but he didn't feel good, so we had the main man, Armando himself, bring us out here. So, beautiful buck, he just put a great shot on it. We're gonna go up here and look. I'm pretty sure I hard shot him, but we wanna make sure, so we're gonna go look for the arrow, look at the blood, but I think he's just dead right over here. So we're gonna track him, see what we can find. There's the trauma. Soaked in blood. That's how you like seeing them right there. A massive gnarly buck with a lot of tines. Well, we came in here tonight, same place I killed the hog in the last night. They knew there were some big eight pointers, and I'm addicted to big eight pointers, but when this buck come out, he's cool. I thought about it for a long time, and then finally he gave me a shot and I couldn't resist. And just what a massively cool buck. Look at him. Las Cuevas Ranch, the Lopez family. Always a great time. Two hunts. I killed on my first hunt both days. Once in the morning, once in the evening. Awesome place.
167.78.
Yeah.
Almost 168.
That's a beast.
What are you bringing that for? I got the big camera.
You'll see. Did you get it?
No.
I did.
Tacticam. Share your hunt.
You ready yet?
I broke my razor.
Try this.
Now that's razor sharp.
Dead ringer. There will be blood.
You know, I killed that first evening. Hunter's there. He brought everything he needed, so he's up to bat.
All right, guys. This is my first hunt here at Las Cuevas Ranch. We got two big bucks in the area we're looking for. We're gonna sit tight, it's super windy. We're hoping that one of them will come in. Sit tight, we're gonna see if we can let the old Barnett wrap
just your tiny one down right there. Well, we were in here hunting another buck, but management buck showed up that they asked if we would take out there, and I'd gladly do that. So I think we put a good shot on him. He actually circled around and started. He ran in here like 20 yards away again, and he was smoked. I could see him go through. I think he's down just right over there, but I'm pumped. That's my first out of country buck. I'm super stoked. Yeah. Nice management buck, right? Nice management buck. Yeah. Yeah. Either one, I'm happy with. I appreciate it, guys.
Harvesting mature whitetails on a consistent basis is no easy task. Stack the odds in your favor with a premier Killer Food Plots blend growing in your favorite hunting location. Killer Food Plots. Setting a new standard in wildlife nutritional products. You reap what you sow.
This week we're going to talk about a broadhead that ends the debate of fixed versus mechanical heads, and that head is the Switchback from Dead Ringer. One of the biggest debates in archery is fixed versus mechanical heads, and now the Switchback completely eliminates that as the first truly hybrid head that lets you go from fixed blade to mechanical by simply changing the collar out. When you have the steel collar inserted on the Switchback, it turns it into a 1-inch cutting diameter fixed blade. This collar system, like most heads that have interchangeable blades, locks the blades in place and won't allow them to deploy. By simply changing out the collar to the machine durable flexible collar, it turns it into a full mechanical head. As with all Dead Ringer heads, they use spring steel instead of cheap carbon steel. What this translates into is a higher grade of steel for you. It's going to be more dependable, stay sharper longer. It's going to flex instead of break. So when you shoot an animal, you're going to get the full cutting diameter all the way through. How many times have you had a broken blade? You won't have that with a Dead Ringer. What truly separates this head from all other heads on the market is its revolutionary interchangeable collar system. By simply removing the steel collar, inserting the flexible collar, you went from fixed to mechanical that fast. If you're like me and you hunt states that don't allow mechanical heads and you don't want to retune your bow when you hunt there, make sure and go to deadringer.com, check out the Switchback and their entire line of great broadheads.
I just shot my buck. It was crazy as heck. I thought we smoked him. And the way he kind of ran off, he just kind of staggered about 20 yards and stood there for like 5 to 10 minutes and didn't move. Look, it looked like I smoked him. And so he eventually staggered over about 20 or 30 yards and laid down.
Look at that. Old gnarly buck. They're saying he's at least 8 or 9 years old, man. This thing is a total bruiser. We tracked this thing, man, for ever. Jumped him once and gave him a little time. I think he exited, I think he was quartered away a little bit on the shot, but it exited just a tad far back. I'm thinking I hit liver and possibly guts, but man, I can't say enough about Las Cuevas, man. If you guys are looking for an incredible hunt, this is a place to be. They treat you like you would never believe, man. This is awesome. So we're going to take him back and have some back straps for dinner tonight. Thanks, James, from Open Season for filming me. I truly appreciate it, man. It's been a great hunt.
When choosing what to feed your deer, you have several options, but your deer only have one. It must contain the vital nutrients their body needs, and it must be palatable. That's why we feed Monster Meal.
Hey, can I use your grizzly again?
No.
A cooler for a lifetime, no matter how you treat it.
What's your favorite thing about the site?
Multifunctional.
Closed captioning brought to you by...
What's yours?
Accuracy.
Spot Hog, world's toughest archery product.
You know, the Lopez family, they're 6 great people Hospitality is second to none. Las Cuevas Ranch, big bucks, and it's a no-brainer if you want to go shoot a buck south of the border.
Join us next week as we show you the trials and tribulations of hunting with a camera. Hey.
We also want to thank these fine sponsors.
Look at my new call. Tickle Rapper. It's new.
You do anything right? That's how you call the big bucks in.
Cherokee Sports. Solutions for the sportsman.